Hello friends. So let us determine the impulse response of a system which is characterized by a difference equation as y of n equals to x of n into 3x of n minus 1 minus 4x of n minus 2 plus 2x of n minus 3. So I have characterized, or I have a system given to me, y of n equals to x of n plus 3x of n minus 1 plus 4x of n minus 2 plus 2x of n minus 3. Now in this difference equation, the point to observe is the output depends only on inputs, that is present and the past inputs. This is my present input and these are all my past inputs. So there are no past outputs. So the output depend on only inputs, okay? So that is a very special type of a difference equation where my output depends only on present and past inputs and no outputs. How to solve this problem? Step one of the solution, replace. Whenever we go for impulse response, we have to replace x of n by delta n and y of n as h of n. Right? So I will replace all x of n's by delta n's and y of n as h of n. So I get h of n equals to delta n plus 3 delta n minus 1 minus 4 delta n minus 2 plus 2 delta n minus 3. Now I will apply step 2, apply Z transform. When I apply Z transform to this equation, I get h of z equals to delta of n is 1 plus 3 z raised to minus 1 into 1, because delta n is 1, n minus 1 we have multiplied by z raised to minus 1, minus 4 z raised to minus 2 into 1 plus 2 z raised to minus 3 into 1. So I have 1 plus 3 z inverse minus 4 z raised to minus 2 plus 2 z raised to minus 3. That is the h of z. Whenever I get such type of h of z which has only numerator and no denominator, that time the problem becomes more simpler. We don't have to apply a partial fraction expansion. Here step 3 is apply inverse z transform, and wherever you have h of z you have to write h of n, wherever you have 1 there you have to. Now here the impulse response will be a set. Either you can write directly a set or you can write in terms of impulses. So I'll write directly first set and then we will go for impulses. So for the set it will be 1, then the next coefficient is, that is z inverse, which is 3, then z raised to minus 2 it is minus 4, z raised to minus 3 is 2. So this is my impulse response, or you can also write it as h of n equals to delta n plus 3 delta n minus 1 minus 4 delta n minus 2 plus 2 delta n minus 3. What does it reflect? Again, I can write it as delta n. This signal exists only at n is equal to 0 and 0 everywhere. So at n is equal to 0, the amplitude is 1. So I write 1. Then I have delta n minus 1. This is shifted impulse by 1. That means this signal will be 1 at n is equal to 1 and 0 everywhere. And what is the amplitude? 3. So I write 3. Next, I have an impulse which is shifted by 2, but the amplitude is minus 4. And I have lastly impulse shifted by 3 and the amplitude is 2. So this is my n is equal to 0. This is my n is equal to 1. This is n is equal to 2 and this is n is equal to 3. So the given impulse response is 1, 3, minus 4, 2. Thank you.